about compression, asphyxia, and how it relates to the overlapping of shields with the hoplites, which is why he has the shield set up here. And why he's here in general. He's sitting on my punching bag, if you couldn't tell, which you probably couldn't. What is compression asphyxia? Compression asphyxia is when you have pressure on your chest that doesn't give your lungs room to expand and you suffocate. Now, how do the lungs work? Well, the lungs are in a low pressure zone and you have your diaphragm right about here. Your diaphragm contracts, giving the zone room to expand, so you can and then it expands. Bleh. Brain fart. Expands, forcing this to close, and that's how you breathe. Now, there's this thing called tension pneumothorax, which I learned about while in the military, where you get shot here, not necessarily the lungs that get punctured, but that low pressure zone that gets compromised, and thus the air pressure on the outside of the lungs causes them to shrink, and you lose a lot of lung efficiency. It's kind of a problem. Now, you need to be able to expand this way, because you can't just expand downward. That's why compression asphyxia is a thing. Some instances of it are at football matches, or as we call them in the States, soccer games. You have the hooligans trying to rush the field. They get pressed against that safety bar, crushed, and they die. While looking for the actual numbers for what it takes to suffocate somebody from chest pressure, I found it's been reported at certain parties where there's a lot of people crammed in, people getting pushed up against the wall and they die. And an interesting one is an air mattress, which was recalled because people would get between it and the bed frame and they die from compression asphyxia, not just run-of-the-mill asphyxia. So it's a bit of an issue, I would say. So some will say that the asphyx, which this is not, helps alleviate the pressure by putting here and on the leg, which you cannot see because the camera doesn't go that far down. So, let's look into that a bit. Now, the rim of the asphyx is about 4 inches, which is about as wide as my hand. I just measured. So, I'm going to put on my Argive shield. Now, it is said that, one thing real quick, my arm, just normal, just kind of hanging there, is about 4 inches wide. Now, the grip here in the middle isn't 4 inches, though. It's just the way the arm squishes that makes that so. Now, put that on. But it doesn't have to be 4 inches wide to actually touch me. As you can see, I knocked that over. Here's about 4 inches, and down here, it's also 4 inches, but it's against my belly. I got a bit of a gut, but just a tiny one. So it's still touching me, even with the 4-inch gap. Now this is about 30 inches, so the rim would be about here and recessed back. So the rim would be here, which as you can tell is right next to my throat. Not a good thing. And hoplites were generally, ancient people in general, were generally shorter, generally speaking. Even the generals were shorter than the average person. I'm about average, about 5'7", 5'8". So this would be even more of an issue. It's right on my throat, even if it was just pressing right here. It slips up, which this is a bit of a slope, so it's not beyond reason. It might slip up, it'd be right on my throat, and yeah, that's a problem. And with the Corinthian helmet hanging down like this, it's not going to do anything. So, bit of an issue. Plus, my arm's already pushing against here. Now, my arm has to be like this. This is the best I can do. If I move it up, it's along my chest, and that's bad. If I move it down, like I'm protecting my junk, I have no strength. I can't resist anything from here. I have my bedpost right here, which is handy. As you can see, I can't resist that, nor can I resist that way. I can't do it. I don't have the strength. Whereas if I'm like this, I can resist. So I have to have my arm laterally. If I move it this way, though, to get my arm off my belly more, well, the rim comes more along right here. But if I move this way, it puts my arm on my belly more, and it kind of kills it. So this is the best I can do. It really is. So it's a bit of a problem now. But we'll grant, for the sake of argument, we'll grant it. We'll say the rim does its job. How am I going to fight? Because I, as he even says himself, a guy named Paul something or another, I forget his last name, he says that they'd have to be squared up. Because if you can't really push like this, it's unstable. So you have to be squared up. I have no power here. This is it. This is all I can do. It's like a boxer just throwing a jab. Just tss. My form's not perfect. But it doesn't have to for this point. This is the arm. I'm not going to be knocking anybody out with just a quick little jab like that. I've got to throw my hips into it. And if I'm pinned like this, there's no hip power. There's nothing. Just this. This is not enough. Let me grab my sword. Even with the sword, this is not much. I can't really do much from here. And if I was getting close, I'd probably want something shorter than this and just be jabbing at people's necks, like a dagger. That would work. A dagger would work. But a weapon like this or a spear, no freaking chance. So you can't fight in a crush. Bit of an issue, I think, when you're fighting a battle. But let's look at this overlap thing now. There's three ways to overlap. Right over left, like this. Left over right, like this. Or not at all. Let's go over. Generally, in my group, we use right over left. Now, we have to do close phalanx, because that's what everyone argues. They fall in close order, that's why they had to use underarm instead of overarm, right? So, here I'm close, right over left. And this is great because I can brace very easily using this bedpost here. I can put my arm and leg and body into it and still deliver good strike and hit the ceiling fan. Still brace and still fight. And this would be pushing against his here. We'd be rotating, we'd be locked together, very sturdy. But, something most you probably wouldn't know. Now, the problem that we don't have is our grips are in the middle, so this bit is free to overlap all at once. But if I'm overlapped, we're in close order. How you doing, buddy? Let's kill these guys. You want to see a problem? That's your problem. Again, this is about the same size, so the room would be out here. Yeah, a bit of an issue, I would say. This shield might save me from the pressure, but his won't. Kind of a problem. I think we all would agree. To avoid that, we have to go like this. Makes more sense. We have all that space to our left anyways. Might as well put it to use, right? Well, forming up like this takes a long time. Even with just a handful of guys, which in our group we often form a boar's snout, or spinvelka, which is a wedge formation. And we'll say he's the center guy. Everyone on his right would be right over left and kind of move back, whereas everyone on my side would be left over right, because if we were like this, you could easily shove a spear through there as we're coming in, and we'd collapse and lose formation. But like this, we're more protected against that. Plus, he can pull his shield back into ours to lock him in, and then at the last moment, boom, spring forward. Works pretty well. But it's very, very slow to form up. Even just a handful of dudes. Five or six guys on each side of this guy. It takes quite some time. Because normally, we're just forming a regular shield wall, standing like this, then boom. They all fall naturally into place. But with this, we got to tuck this way, come around, then he's got to do the same. It's very, very slow. Not that beneficial either, because using the bedpost, if somebody's pushing here, which I'm going to do by leaning back, I naturally turn. This way I can brace myself well and not fall over, but here I can't. If I put my weapon arm here and brace this way, I can. But if my weapon's braced here, how am I going to fight? I need my right side in order to stab with my spear, but I can't brace here and pokey pokey. Now can I? If I move my arm, I'm gone. Because, well, going this way with the arm, there's bracing, but there's not bracing this way. Like, if I'm going to put my arm here, I can hold firm, but out, I can't. So, you're not very well braced. It's not a good formation. But, lastly, no overlap. What's the point of overarm? If we're not overlapping? That's just one issue. And when you're pushing, you got another issue. There's a tactic to beat spear walls where one guy pushes spears this way and the guy next to him pushes the other spears this way to make a gap. And the second rank starts to push through. So if somebody's pushing him, they kind of nudge, why don't you go this way a little more? They're pushing on me, why don't you go this way a little more? I think you can see the problem here. Somebody could easily just plow right through. And somebody, even like this, somebody that's a little more ballsy can tuck in behind their shield, go like this, and just push right between us without much difficulty. So if you're going to be in a shoving match, you kind of need to be right next to each other. Otherwise, somebody's just going to go right through you. And there's no fucking point to overarm if you have plenty of room to do this. So you need to be overlapping, but if you're overlapped right over left, you're dead. Left over right, you're not braced. So, a bit of an issue, I would say. So, with that, Tally's taking home.